Now, it's a sad fact that one in three of us will be diagnosed with cancer during our lifetime. A new star-studded play about the challenges of living with the disease has now come to the Midlands this evening.
It promises to inspire and encourage those who've been affected by the illness. The play tells the stories of five women surviving various types of cancer. All the money goes to Macmillan Cancer Support. Rajiv Popat went along to the rehearsals.
I am a survivor of stage 4 terminal ovarian cancer. Said it. It's an amazing feeling being able to sit here and say it without bursting into tears.
The important thing about this play is it focuses on the positive, and it, as the story develops, you're taken on a journey, really, and hopefully to uplift you. And my aim really was to ensure that for people who were living cancer-free, I wanted to perhaps enlighten them, and for people who were living with cancer, to empower them.
These amazing women that are here, whose stories we're telling, are just inspirational, really, and I'm sure that a lot of people can take, you know, comfort from their sort of experiences and their stories.
But I felt really weak, and I was scared. So I called the doctor and made an appointment.
And that's all you're having for now, young man.
It's quite frightening. One in three people are hit by one form of cancer or another. And it's funny, the older you get, the more and more people you realise around you are being touched by it. Suddenly you hit 30 years old, even though I'm a little bit older than 30 now, but won't tell anyone. You hit 30 and suddenly everybody you know someone's mum, your friend, da-da-da, and it's indiscriminate. It just can hit anyone at any time. It's a hideous disease.
And there's something about a man crying. You know, it does thing inside you. And as I watched him, I realised our lives would never be the same again.
All of us in it are so proud to be helping Macmillan to raise the awareness of what they can do to help people of all kinds of cancer can survive with the right help, which Macmillan provide.
The first performance is this evening. There's another matinee show tomorrow at 2:30, and the final performance is tomorrow evening. If it's successful, it will tour the country. Rajiv Popat in Solihull for Central Tonight.
That's incredible, isn't it? One in three.
Later, I was back at the hospital having tests. Some were a little bit embarrassing, but it would all be sorted and I could get myself back to work. They were very efficient. And the nurse that dealt with me, Judith, she was lovely. She commented on my Louis Vuitton bag. She asked me all sorts of questions about my work in advertising. She seemed very, very interested. I wondered why she hadn't gone into that line of business herself.
And 2 years ago, I gave up again because I was so sick of looking at those packets with smoking kills on it. I thought, right, well, I better give up. And I did. With the help of patches and gum, I managed it.
So there I am, draped over the bed, with my arms up over my head, in my tight black trousers and red shiny shoes, feeling just a little bit tarty. And who should walk in but the porter with the ultrasound machine. So he takes one look at me and goes, whoa, you all right, love? I've spent the next 3 weeks in hospital, going through the chemotherapy, the drugs, various treatments, losing weight, not eating enough, losing more weight, friends coming and going, and all of this with a smile on my face.
The anger was unleashing, and you know, afterwards, it just constantly bubbled and surfaced, lashing out at the smallest thing, a kind word or a kindly word of advice. But all I could see was my life flashing before me, and I just wanted to scream, why me? What have I done to deserve this? I was 15, for Christ's sake, 15.